Good evening, Noodle, and I would like to welcome you to the second annual Wine in the Wild to benefit the Bush Wildlife Sanctuary. My name's Amy Kite. I am the executive director of Bush Wildlife, and my friend here, Noodle, so aptly named because he was found in a swimming pool, so he was a pool noodle, is an American alligator. And we are in front of our brand new American alligator enclosure that we recently constructed at the sanctuary. You know, this year is quite different. Last year for our first annual Wine in the Wild, you were here with us and it was a wonderful event and I think everybody had so much fun. And unfortunately, with 2020 being what it is, we've had to go virtual this year. But I assure you, we'll do everything we can to give you all the information about the sanctuary, about all the wonderful things going on here, and of course about all that wonderful food and drinks that you have there for you. We've got amazing sponsors this year who we could not have done this without. As with all the time, our donors are so important to us. You are the ones that keep our mission going, and that is to rescue, rehabilitate, and release wild animals native to Florida back into their natural habitats. With that comes the need for education. And we have seen so far over 2 million visitors in the history of Bush Wildlife come through here to learn about our native animals and our natural resources here in South Florida. So tonight, sit back, enjoy, have a drink, see our animals. They're so happy to have you guys with us. I'm gonna introduce you to one of our sponsors and partners, which is Jackson Family Wines. They are here today. I've got Garth and I've got Heather, and they're gonna tell you all about the deliciousness you have in front of you.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us at Bush Wildlife's virtual event with Jackson Family Wines. Garth and I are really excited to talk to you all about the wines and the charcuterie board, as well as the Jackson family. Jackson Family Wines are all certified sustainable. Jackson Family owns 35,000 acres in the US, and 60% of the land that we own isn't planted to vine. We leave that for wildlife and biodiversity.
Just like Bush Wildlife, the Jackson family has a rich and interesting history. The company was born out of something some people would call as a midlife crisis. No, Jess didn't go out and buy a fancy car. No, he didn't get a motorcycle. No, he didn't even get a girlfriend. Jess was an attorney in San Francisco. He had reached his mid-50s and wanted to move his family out of wine country. He wanted his daughters to grow up in the country and respecting the property that and the land that he grew up with his grandparents in the Midwest. He and his daughters and his wife moved up to Lake County. They planted a small 72-acre plot. On that plot, the Jackson family history was born. Each year, we grew little bit by little bit, trials and tribulations. Our first few years are rough, just like 2020 has been for so many of us. The first few years, we were doing great. We sold our fruit to other winemakers, and then in 1982, we had a wine glut. Our big harvest. Jess was unable to sell his fruit, so he decided to make his own wine. And then Jackson Family Wines was born.
And Cambria Wines was founded. So the Jackson family, Jess and Barbara Benke, bought Cambria back in 86, and that was the year their daughter Catherine was born, and that's gonna be the first Chardonnay that we taste. So this is down in Santa Maria County, where you've got a lot of maritime influences. It's also where the mountain ranges run east to west, and it's the only place that that happens in the US. So you get this really cold fog, refrigerated sunshine in the vineyards during a lot of the day, which creates a lot of acidity and texture in the wine. Catherine is the Chardonnay, and Juliet, who was born 2 years later in 88, was who the Pinot Noir vineyards were named after. Both wines were in the top 100. In 2019, the Chardonnay made the list, and this year in 2020, the Julius Pinot made the list. So I hope you guys all enjoy and can drink this Chardonnay with us. We're gonna swirl it to get that aerated aromas in the wine, and then we're gonna give it a nice smell. Oh, there's beautiful citrus in this glass. There's Granny Smith apple. There's even candied pineapple, some really nice tropical notes.
Love the vanilla that I'm getting on the texture and the aroma.
And Garth, that's coming from the little bit of oak that they use on this. In your mouth, you're gonna get this really beautiful texture and bright acidity. There's definitely a floral component too. Orange blossoms, a little bit of vanilla, but just this beautiful, strong acidity through the finish, which is a great pairing with some of the cheeses you have in front of you. And then we'll talk a little bit about the Pinot Noir. So as I said earlier, this is all coming from Santa Maria Valley down in Santa Barbara County. And the soils here are this ancient marine sediment, which also lends a nice mineral component to the wine. Also, these aren't low-lying vineyards. All of the fruit from the estate comes from the bench going up into the mountain range there. So really nice depth within the wine. This Pinot Noir is gonna have beautiful notes of raspberry and cranberry. Even a cherry cola thing is going on there with some nice baking spices. A perfect pairing for Thanksgiving dinner with cranberries and turkey. Sweet potatoes, turkey with those baking spices and apple pie.
Delicious, nice long clean finish, back with that beautiful acid strain. Texture is nice and a little bit of a velvety, smooth and sensual.
Hi, I'm Lisa Nguyen, Assistant Director at Busch Wildlife Sanctuary. And this is Esther, an animal ambassador here at the sanctuary. Esther is a burrowing owl, and she came to Busch through our wildlife hospital. Esther was found in a warehouse flying around. The workers there were able to catch her after a couple days and noticed something was wrong with her eye. They brought her to Busch Wildlife, and as part of her treatment and medical care, unfortunately, we had to remove her eye. Eyesight is really important for owls to hunt, so Esther can't be released back into the wild. She will live here at the sanctuary as an animal ambassador, teaching people about burrowing owls and also how to coexist with wildlife. The first part of our mission here at Busch Wildlife is to rescue injured, sick, and orphan wildlife. We are on track this year to rescue almost 6,000 animals, a record number for us, up 20% since 2018. From baby birds, baby opossums, squirrels, to bobcats, alligators, bald eagles, and more. Many of the animals are brought in due to human-related causes, such as hit by cars, poisoned, or attacked by a dog or cat. I have worked at Busch for 2 years and have learned so much about the enormous number of wildlife we help each day. There are days when staff treat over 30 new patients. People see animals in need and want to help. The majority of our patients are brought in by caring community members who find injured, sick, and orphan wildlife, as well as our amazing volunteer rescuers who go above and beyond to help animals in need. I've been so impressed with the passion and dedication of volunteers and staff who tirelessly care for these animals 7 days a week, 365 days a year.
Good evening. And welcome to Wine in the Wild. I'm Peter Busch, chairman of the Busch Wildlife Sanctuary, and I'm happy to be here with you all tonight. This is going to be something that I don't think we have ever done before, so we're out there doing it the first time. I think it's going to be interesting to see what kind of participation we got. I think it's going to be a fun evening, and I'm really looking forward to you all seeing this event live tonight. In addition, I got to thank you all so much for your support, for the money that you have given to the sanctuary, for your care and love of the animals that we care for and love. And we could not have done it without you. So sincerely, from the bottom of my heart, and I know our board, and I know our staff members as well, thank you very much and have a great evening.
Part of tonight's experience is learning about the Jackson family wines and properties. The Jackson family, over the years, has amassed properties in California, Oregon, Argentina, Australia, New Zealand, South Africa,
Italy, and France.
Thank you. And one of our favorite wineries that we like to talk about is La Crema. La Crema di Venera was the original name of this winery, started in 1979. It means best of the vine. La Crema is all about microclimate, cool climate, Pinot Noirs, Chardonnays, and this year we just released first ever Sauvignon Blanc. We also make rosé and a sparkling from Sonoma as well. Tonight we're going to highlight our Sonoma Coast and flagship Chardonnay from La Crema, La Crema Sonoma Coast Chardonnay 2018 vintage. This is the number 4 selling Chardonnay in America currently, and the top 10 in Florida. What you're gonna experience in this wine, opposite of what you had in Cambria, is a little bit more green apple. Again, citrus tones will fill your glass. The aroma here is bright, light fruit. The acid in this wine is nice and crisp and can cut through those tannins in the cheeses that you have on your plate. We like to talk about the vanilla tones in this wine. It comes from the French oak that we use at La Crema. Everything that we use at Jackson Family is predominantly French oak from our estates in France. We own our own stave mill, and we're the only American company to own our own stave mill, and the only American company that will ever own their own stave mill due to French law. So back to what's in the glass. Again, I mentioned candied apple, crisp acid, bright citrus fruit.
You get a lot of this round component and texture on this Chardonnay in comparison to that bright acidity that you got from Cambria, and that's due to the oak regimen that it sees. It's not a buttery, heavy style, but there's a little bit more roundness to it in the glass.
I love the weight in this Chardonnay. It really makes this wine stand up to a numerous amount of cheeses. Now onto the Pinot Noir. This is a top 4 selling Pinot Noir in the state of Florida. It's funny, as hot as it is here in Florida and tonight in Busch Wildlife, we drink more Pinot Noir in Florida than we do Chardonnay. It's an anomaly among most states in the United States. Jackson Family plants 63% of our vineyards to Chardonnay and 29% to Pinot Noir, so we love our Burgundy varietals. This wine, just like Cambria, but a little bit different as far as you're gonna get brighter, rich cherry. You're not gonna have that plum or that raspberry that we had in Cambria, but bright, rich cherry. Again, the texture of this wine that you have in your glass is rich and unctuous. This is gonna pair well with a lot of the cold cuts that are on your plate. Back to mouthfeel, a little bit weightier than Cambria, has a little bit more body and texture. So a little bit riper fruit and a lot more bright cherry.
Well, hello everybody. My name is Mangrove Mark. I just want to say how honored and privileged it is to be here playing again for you all. Such an awesome place. Anything we can do for the animals is just a beautiful thing. Keep them in mind. We were born before the wind, also younger than the sun. Let the bonny boat sail into the mist. I can hear the sailors cry, smell the sea, feel the sky. Let your soul and spirit fly into the mystery. That foghorn blows, will I be coming home? That foghorn whistle blows, I don't want to hear it, I don't want to fear it. Well, I won't rock your gypsy soul, just like way back in the days of old. We magnificently sailed way to the misty. Well, I won't rock your gypsy way back in the days of old, way back if the sin we sailed, way to the mystery.
Coordinator here at Bush Wildlife Sanctuary. Now, you might have had a few glasses of wine by now, but you're seeing this correctly. This is a skunk. This is Parker, and she is quite the party animal. She is showing you exactly why she's here at the sanctuary. You see, a lot of people like to keep skunks as pets, and I don't know why. They're stinky, they're smelly, and they scratch all over the place. But people do it. And when they do, they have their glands surgically removed, which basically renders Parker here defenseless from being outside. She's basically a big fluffy meatball. Now, when she is no longer wanted as a pet inside somebody's home, she gets surrendered to a wildlife sanctuary like Bush. We are so excited to have Parker as one of our beautiful education ambassadors, and we hope you come to see her soon. If you've ever been to one of the sanctuary's programs, you know that we pride ourselves on our education. Education is a huge component of Bush Wildlife's core message. We not only provide programs to the local guests and community, but we aim to encourage young, curious minds with our Junior Naturalist and Mini Junior Naturalist program. From ages 5 to 14, our juniors are invited to create new connections with nature, conservation, and even up-close animal encounters with our ambassadors, like Parker. I personally feel extremely lucky to get to teach these nature nerds, as I call them, and see the light bulb moments go off when they realize that they are part of the solution too. We feel that is important that you learn about these animals to be able to love them, and then we'll want to help them like we do too. Since these animal ambassadors do provide such a service to our sanctuary and our programs, we strive to give as much as we can back to them in return. So, sometimes we partner with local stores like Trader Joe's to provide new snacks to their diets, or our juniors and volunteers take part in creating fun enrichment activities for them. And we absolutely love watching them explore places that they have never been before. So from Parker and the rest of our education ambassadors, cheers.
Hey you guys, this is Madeline Montgomery. I am the wildlife reporter for CBS 12 News. And I'm pretty much always bothering Bush Wildlife to see if I can hang out with somebody like Pretzel the snake. I also bother them because I like to go get wine with Amy every now and then. And so for me, tonight is perfect because we get a little bit of both. We get some alcohol, we get some cheese and crackers, and we get to see some of the amazing animals here. And what I love about Bush Wildlife is that they help rehabilitate our animals in our area that are hurt, as well as introduce families to the animals that live right here in Florida. So they're really a place that I love, and I hope you guys love them too and can give back to them. For now, cheers.
So I'm going to talk to you a little bit about Matanzas Creek Sauvignon Blanc. That's one of our wineries in Sonoma. What's really cool about this winery is we actually have owl boxes on property, just like Bush Wildlife has 5 different species of owl on property. Our uses for the owls are a little bit different, but a part of our sustainability concept isn't using pesticides. So what we use for pesticides or other wineries do is to keep the birds away. What we do is we have the owl boxes up, so the owls are a natural bird deterrent from eating our berries at harvest time. We have beautiful lavender fields all across the winery, which also help for another deterrent of animal life, and that's deer. Deer do not like lavender, and it keeps them away from eating our berries as well. Matanzas Creek Winery was founded in 1977, and the original winemaker was Mary Edwards. Another really popular, highly accredited winemaker was David Ramey, who was another one of the original winemakers on property. Jackson family bought this in 2001, and since has produced incredible rated, outstanding wines, ranging from Sauvignon Blanc, Merlot, and Chardonnay, and growing the vineyards into Knights Valley and other parts of Sonoma in Alexander Valley. Sauvignon Blanc is a really popular drink for Florida because of its bright acidity, really fresh lemon, lime, honeydew components. A lot of times people are drinking New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc that has this grapefruit, herbaceous, green pepper notes that's really aromatic. This, while it has beautiful aromatics, isn't as strong or tart as that. It's got much more floral, melon, lemon, lime, a little bit of herbaceous notes too, and just really beautiful to drink in a hot summer day. So what's really cool about Matanzas Sauv Blanc, unlike most New Zealand's, is that they actually blend a little bit of Semillon into this. That kind of cuts that tart acidity that you get from New Zealand Sauv Blancs and gives it more of this floral, melon, honeydew, and really beautiful mouthfeel versus that harsh acidity that you get from some of the New Zealand's. There's this beautiful lemon lime zest that I'm getting, really fleshy fruit, even a little bit of apricot. So the Matanzas Creek Sauv Blanc is also gonna pair really wonderful with the charcuterie board from Salut. The Manchego cheese you have in front of you, that sharper cheese, is really gonna be a nice comparison to this wine. The soft flavors of this are gonna cut that hardiness of the cheese, and if you chew the cheese and drink the wine at the same time, they're really gonna show off each other's assets.
So I hope you've noticed there's been a common thread in tonight's wine presentation. It's all about families. As we mentioned earlier, Jackson Family is comprised of over 52 different wineries, and we've purchased these wineries throughout the years. Jackson Family, as we mentioned earlier, leaves 60% of the vineyards unplanted. But what else do we do? We also care about sustainability. In our view, sustainability is not only what we do in the vineyard, it's how our workers get to the vineyard and what we do with our waste afterwards. We've partnered with Tesla to power our wineries during peak times. A lot of times during fermentation, our wineries are solely operating on solar power. We are the largest provider for solar energy in the state of California for all wineries. We make several varieties at Murphy Good: Pinot Noir, Cabernet, Sauvignon Blanc, Pinot Grigio, Merlot, and a red blend. Tonight's pairing, we're gonna talk about Sauvignon Blanc. What makes Murphy Good Sauvignon Blanc different from Matanzas that Heather talked about a minute ago? Well, first off, this comes from North Coast. Not only is it Sonoma, but it's Mendocino counties. So Mendocino is a little bit north, and it's neighboring there of Lake County, where this whole journey started. So what is this Sauvignon Blanc gonna taste like? Well, Sauvignon Blanc is typically grapefruit. You get a nice, rich grapefruit on the nose. Not so much New Zealand cut grass, but really ripe citrus grapefruit. The weightiness of this wine, we talked about that with several of our wines. This has got a nice weightiness to it, a texture, sort of like when you think about wines, not 1%, not 2%, not whole milk, right? Those are the things that we can characterize about wines that talk about weight that we all experience. So this is gonna be more like skim milk, okay? So a little bit lighter in style, lighter in body. I mean, again, grapefruit and citrus tones. Nice tones, nice citrus fruits. Grapefruit is the lead character there. And again, this is gonna pair well with the Manchego provided by Salut Market.
Hi, my name is Rebecca Reed, and I'm the Director of Education at Bush Wildlife Sanctuary. And this is Cash. Cash is a fish crow. Now, he came into the sanctuary as a little baby. And when I say little baby, he was actually kind of the biggest baby I've ever seen. And when he came in, it was right at the end of April, at the beginning of May, right when we shut down due to COVID. So he's my little COVID baby. Now, when he was developing, as we were raising him up, we realized that his wing was being kind of weird. He was holding it up a little bit higher than the other wing. So I took him over to the hospital where he got an X-ray, and we realized that his wing was broken. So Cash will actually never fly, and he has made his way into our education department where he is a wonderful member of our animal ambassador team. Our wildlife hospital intakes more than 5,000 injured, sick, and orphaned wild animals every single year. The main goal is to release those animals back out into the wild. Many of them we're able to release right away. However, some of them we need to keep for a while, maybe set them up in a little bit of a hospital bed, help that animal to feel better, rehabilitate that animal, and then release it back out into the wild. When releasing many of the animals back into their natural habitat, it's very important to find a suitable home for them. Therefore, we've partnered with Palm Beach County Environmental Resources Management, or ERM, and have adopted 6 natural areas. We work with biologists to find the animals the best home possible. It's so bittersweet when you release an animal back out into the wild. The main reason is because you've kind of become attached to the animal. You've watched them grow, you've watched them change, you've watched them develop, and releasing them, it's like you're just sending them off into the wild. You don't know what's going to happen to them, but you're like, Godspeed, little creature. Like, good luck. I hope you make lots and lots of babies.
She's a good girl, loves her mama. Oh, she's in America too. She's a good girl. She's crazy about her best, loves horses and a boyfriend too. Yeah. It's a long day living in Reseda. There's a freeway, run me the yard. I'm a bad boy, we don't even miss her. I'm a bad boy, breaking her heart, and now I'm free. I'm free for now. Yes, I'm free. All damn right, run through the valley, go west down, then go to the bar. All the bad boys standing in the shadows, all the good girls, all broken hearts, and now I'm free. Yeah, free falling now. Yes, I'm free. I wanna glide down, go to my hollin, I wanna ride home, naming the sky, I'm gonna free fall, out into nothing, I'm gonna leave this world for a while. Free falling.
Hi everyone, my name is Alon Coffer and I'm the Vice Mayor of the Town of Jupiter. Thank you for joining us tonight for Wine in the Wild with Bush Wildlife. I don't have to remind you how important Bush Wildlife is to our community and what a great asset they have been over the years. I hope you're at home enjoying a nice glass of wine and some tasty treats tonight and enjoying the event that we have prepared for you. And we thank you for joining us and supporting Bush Wildlife. My family and I have been frequent visitors to Bush Wildlife over the years. From the time our kids were little babies in strollers to now 6 and 4 years old and seeing them run around and check out all the wildlife and give us their names. Thank you to all the volunteers and staff who make Bush Wildlife such a great place to visit and give our wildlife an opportunity to get back into the wild. We have a unique opportunity here in Jupiter and the surrounding communities to provide injured wildlife with an opportunity to get back into the wildlife. And we're grateful for all that you do as supporters of Bush Wildlife to make that happen. Please remember that Bush Wildlife can't do all these great things without your continued support. So I hope you have a wonderful rest of the evening and enjoy the rest of the event. And cheers to you and for all your support for Bush Wildlife.
The next wine I'm going to talk to you guys about is Siduri. If you look at the label, you've got this beautiful woman wrapped with rolling blue waves, a wine glass in her hand, and a grape. This woman on the label is the Babylonian wine goddess, and that's what Adam Lee created his winery around. Adam Lee was one of Robert Parker's darlings, kind of by chance, over 2 decades ago, and he currently makes just over 2 dozen Pinot Noirs and is our resident Pinot Noir expert at Jackson Family. What's really cool about the Siduri and Adam Lee story is when he first started making wine, they dropped off a bottle at a hotel where Robert Parker, one of the most famed wine critics, was staying and left it for him at the front desk. They had drank a little bit of wine that night. And the next morning when they woke up, they went to that hotel and tried to get the bottle back, and it was too late. Robert Parker had already woken up, had already tasted the wine, and they were a little embarrassed. A couple weeks later, their phone rang. It was Robert Parker. He wanted to know what he was tasting, and Adam Lee let him know. And a couple months later, there it was, an incredible waiting in Wine Spectator, letting everybody know about this super small, out of their home winery, the wine that they had just created. Fast forward now, Robert Parker has free range for all of our Jackson Family Pinot Noir projects. That's ranging from Oregon, Yamhill Carlton, Willamette, all the way to Napa, Sonoma, Russian River, Anderson Valley, down into Santa Barbara, Monterey, all of our properties. He really gets first dibs on all of our grapes to make each one of his individual projects. The wine we're tasting tonight is going to be from the Santa Lucia Highlands, and that's just inside Monterey. So what's really cool about these vineyard sites is it's cold. It's raised right along the mountain range there in Santa Lucia Highlands, and you've got this really cold weather flowing in from the Monterey Bay that keeps the wine and acidity levels really high. So what's really cool about this, and when we taste this wine, you're gonna get that bright acidity in the glass. And you're definitely gonna get those cherry notes on the nose, even a little bit of mushroom herbaceousness to it. Also that Bing tart cherry. This is gonna pair really nice with a lot of the charcuterie and meats on the board. I always say pork's a great pairing for Pinot, whether it's prosciutto or soppressata or any kind of sausage. That spice that you're finding in those meats is gonna pair really nice with the baking spices that you're gonna get in the wines.
Mm-hmm. So we've had a wonderful journey tonight through many destinations in the wine country of California. Let's recap those really quickly. So we started out with Murphy Good, Sauvignon Blanc in North Coast, Napa, Sonoma, Mendocino counties. Then we traveled further down into Alexander Valley, which is in Sonoma, and we tasted Matanzas Creek Sauvignon Blanc. Two dualities of Sauvignon Blanc. I hope you noticed the two characteristics and the difference in each of those. Then we traveled down to Cambria in Santa Barbara County. We tasted the wonderful Catherine Chardonnay and Julia's Pinot Noir. Then we traveled back up to La Crema in Sonoma, and the heart of Russian River is where we produce those wines. And finally, we're traveling back down to Siduri in Monterey, where we talked about refrigerated sunshine and the cool climate and the translongitudinal valleys that run through Monterey and Santa Barbara. And again, our last stop is Arrowood, Sonoma Estates, famed winery started by Dick Arrowood in 1985. Dick Arrowood had his claim to fame with Chateau Saint-Jean. I'm sure many of you have tried their wonderful wines. Tonight, we're gonna have their Cabernet, the Sonoma Estates Cabernet. It comes from three estates. We've talked about properties tonight. We talked about Sonoma, we talked about Napa, we talked about Alexander Valley. This is coming from three vineyards, Kellogg Vineyard and the Smothers Brothers Vineyard, and then our Alexander Valley estate. You guys might recognize the name Smothers Vineyard. Yes, it's owned by the two famous comedians from earlier in this century. So tonight, this wine is gonna pair well with Salud's fine meat array that you've tasted tonight. We have a blend of Cabernet, Merlot, Petit Verdot, and Malbec in this wine. Characteristics you're gonna taste in this wine is you're gonna get a little bit of tobacco, a little bit of leather, a little bit of toughness in this wine. This is a man's drinking cab. But I love the subtleness and the soft body that this wine provides that can go well with the cheeses that you've had tonight as well. This truly is a wine drinker's dream. It has that ruggedness that you'd like for a Cabernet drinker, and then that softness that Merlot brings to this particular bottling. Let's see what we have on the nose. Again, raspberry, rich raspberry. I get a little bit of cranberry in this. I get a little tobacco, as we talked about a minute ago. Let's talk about the body and the mouthfeel. Definitely big, weighty, more like whole milk. We talked about the different styles of milk and how you relate that to wine. So whole milk, full body, really gonna stand up to those cheeses. I get a lot of tannins on the sides of my cheeks, really tightening and making my mouth water. Which is perfect for these cheeses. This is exactly what cheeses were meant to do, was withstand the tannins. And then finally, let's talk about flavor profile. Is this baked or is this dry fruit? Is this ripe fruit? I'm getting a lot of ripe fruit, a lot of bright fruit in my glass of wine. So tonight, I think this is gonna do really well with the cheeses you have on the board and the meats that you have on the board. Cheers, and I hope you enjoy.
Here's one of our fan favorites. This is Grayson. She is one of our gray foxes that lives here at Bush Wildlife Sanctuary, and she is one of our educational ambassadors. You can tell right off the bat this animal has been rescued and unfortunately not rehabilitated successfully. That is why she behaves this way. She was actually an animal that was being kept illegally as a pet. And even though our goal is to get these animals back out in the wild, we do have to recognize when rehabilitation is not possible. When it comes to rehab, you've got different terms that are used. Of course, you have animals that are medically injured. They have a broken wing, or like Esther that you met earlier, who is unfortunately missing an eye thanks to injury. You have animals that also come in and there's a problem in their behavior that keeps them from being rehabilitated. So the animals come to us. The goal is always to get them back out in the wild. If that is not possible, we try to offer them salvation here at the sanctuary and they can live here and have their new life. With rehabilitation, it's where I began and it's really where my heart's at, honestly, but you see all kinds of things. So when we're talking about rehabilitation, the animals are coming into our wildlife hospital. And the goal, of course, is to get them stable first. So any kind of fluids, pain management. So many people don't think about the fact that animals feel pain and they can perceive pain and stress in these situations that they're not used to. From there, we examine them and we can do diagnostics, whether that be x-rays, ultrasounds, blood work. We call in specialists We've got wonderful veterinarians in the community who donate their time to us, from general practice vets, exotic vets, even ophthalmologists and veterinary surgeons that donate their services and skills because they kind of enjoy not only helping these animals, but it's something different to their daily routine. Many of the injuries that we're treating here aren't always something that is physical. With Grayson's situation, she was being kept illegally as a pet. Therefore, it's not that her physical injuries prevent her from going in the wild, but it's the way she behaves. She's extremely reliant upon people, and if we were to try to put her back in the wild, there's a fear that she would actually approach people. Not only would that be scary for the person, but they might actually retaliate against her, not understanding her situation and her story, and we would hate for any human or animal to get injured due to lack of improper rehab. She is actually an animal that would be considered habituated, meaning she knows she's a fox, but she's too used to humans to go back out in the wild. We work very hard as rehabilitators to make sure that when the animals come to us, we keep our distance from them. We handle them as little as possible and provide the necessary care, putting every precaution in place to make sure these animals can successfully return to the wild.
Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Garth and I have had an incredible time here at Bush Wildlife Sanctuary, not just drinking the incredible Jackson family wines or eating the beautiful charcuterie board from Salute Market, but getting to know all of the staff here and the incredible animals.
Thank you for this opportunity, I appreciate it. And don't forget, Bush Wildlife, greatest place on the planet. Help them out when you can. Thank you.
We've met a lot of wonderful personalities tonight. Not only with our furry friends, our scaly friends, our feathered friends, but also our wine personalities that you've had in the glass. We hope you enjoy, and we hope you come back tomorrow and in the future and support Bush Wildlife Sanctuary. Cheers, and have a happy new year.
Cheers.
And cheers to you and for all your support for Bush Wildlife.
Thank you very much, and have a great evening.
Cheers.
Just wanted to say thank you so very much for being part of Wine in the Wild and for supporting Bush Wildlife Sanctuary. Really hope you had a wonderful time, just as much fun as we had putting it together for you. And I have to take a moment and thank our very generous sponsors. You'll see at the end of the program, all of them listed. We would love for you to go check them out, support them. This is the community which keeps Bush Wildlife going. So it's cyclical. It just has to happen for everybody to take care of each other. That being said, don't forget to go over to our online auction. It closes at 9 o'clock, so you need to hurry up and get your last minute bids in there. There's wonderful spa treatments and gift cards. We've got gift baskets and beautiful artwork. So those organizations also donated to us, and we wanna make sure to support them. All the proceeds come back. You can also help us out by donating towards a part-time veterinarian, something the sanctuary is desperately in need of. Thank you again for everything and for joining us tonight. Wish you a wonderful evening and the happiest of holidays.
Yes, we do. We've got you a new place to live. Let's shoot her out this way. Yeah. All right. out there and thrive. All right, here we go. Ready, bud? All right, let's see you go. There we go. Now go the other way. Don't come to me. And that's what it's all about. There's the money shot. There he goes.
There he goes.
Oh, go in my van.
Awesome.
That's a good release right there.